which is like what you see here. It's just a one piece that folds over, has a stand in the back, and the shape here could be more angled, less angled, what have you. For any collar, you need first to have your neckline, so you need a bodice. And as you can see here, I've just got a little sort of dickie, which is sufficient for just doing the collars. But it's sewn together at the shoulders. I have an inch extension on each center front, and I've given myself a quarter inch seam allowance around the neck, and I stay stitched it so that I could see my seam line. I need to know where that neck line is, because that's what I'll mark my collar to. That's where they would sew together in the final version. Okay, to the table. I've got my, are we ready? Yes. I've got my muslin torn and ready to go, pressed. My grain, my straight grain on this piece is going this direction. The collar that I just took off the form has the straight grain going parallel to center back. So we're going to compare the two. This one, the straight grain will be going perpendicular to center back. So I'm going to mark center back. It's a symmetrical collar. I only need to drape half of it. And I'm going to work on the opposite side from where that one was pinned. So this will be my neckline. And really, you kind of draft in your drape to a degree. If you've ever drafted a convertible collar, you know it's pretty simple. I'm going to give myself a guideline, and then when you draft, you come out to your shoulder and then you swoop up about half of an inch to center front for your neckline. So I am going to put a half inch guideline as well, and I'll just shoot for my neckline, kind of shaping like that. I could also make marks for my stand height if I knew that I wanted it to only have an inch stand or something. But for now, I'm just going to let it be, and I will determine all that as I drape. So now we're ready to go back to the drape. Okay. Yeah. To start our collar, I'm going to line up center back and get the neckline pinned right through to this line. So it's line to line. And I try not to grab a lot of fabric when I'm pinning these collars. It's a little hard to go perpendicular to the seam because of the shape of the dress form here. So I just try to get some small bits pinned through. And I'm only pinning to my dickie. I'm not catching the dress form, so that's important. And we just work it around to the shoulder. Now you can see it's having a hard time laying flat, so I need to clip to release. And I can clip pretty close to my guideline. And because I used a contrasting thread for my stay stitching, I can see it through the muslin. And I'm still just matching my guideline to that stitching line. And here I am at the shoulder. So my objective is to stay as straight as I can in the back neck area on the collar. And then in the front, I will start to shape some, trying to get center front to intersect with this guideline that I drew. So more clipping to make it all lay smooth. Some of that. I went about 12 inches long by 6 or so inches wide. Now the plan is to have it fold over and come around. When we fold, we have to make sure that center back stays on center back, because if I pull it like that, then we won't be able to just mirror it off of center back and stay symmetrical. So maybe now's a good time to determine stand height. That looks pretty good. So I'm going to get that line to line here. And I will secure right here into the form, just so I don't pull it off. I can clip some of this as well, because I'll need it to release. But I don't want to go past my neckline. And let's come back to the front, see how it's shaping up. There's that guideline, a half of an inch up. Maybe I'll pin to center front. And see what I can do from here. So you see, it's saying, oh, release me. But we're probably also going to have to do some more work on the neckline. I'm kind of pulling away here even. So what you'll find draping collars is that a very slight change in where the neckline is placed can have a pretty big impact on the shape of the collar. So this is a good exercise in paying attention to the fine details. I'm starting to come away from my straight guideline, and I'm just pinning through now to the neckline, catching those red stitches. Still just grabbing this, not pinning to the dress form. And let's fold you back down. So you do a lot of back and forth with your collars. I'm going to give it one more secure pin at center back. What I'm looking for is a nice smooth roll line. The shape, height, and all that I'm desiring, whatever that might be. And I do want some ease here. I don't want that collar to be like up here sort of choking the wearer. So you can think about, is there room sort of for my pencil in there? At the moment, you know, we're looking pretty good. I do want to have my fold hit right there. So this is my roll line of my collar, and I want it to end at center front. So I've got to make sure all of that is happening. I'm going to give it a little more trimming away here. What can happen is that we get a little too far away from the bodice with our outer edge. You know, we want it to just rest on the bodice. And sometimes there can be too much air. I'm not happy about how that's flying up right there. Let's work a little on the neckline to adjust that, because that's where we will change the tightness of the curve. What if I drop that down just a little more? Dropping down just a little further back. That's looking better, I think. Do I still have the ease, though, up here? Let me check with my pencil and get it pinned well to the whole front. Oh, yeah. She fits in there. Okay, I think I can do some marking now. For the outside style line, if I wanted to use some style tape, I could, but I could also just mark it in with my pencil. Just making some dots right now. And of course, we will have to take this down to the table to true up. Now I need to open it up so I can see the neckline and mark it. So along the back, I just stayed with that guideline. I definitely want a cross mark at my shoulder intersection. And then I'll just make some dots along my red stitching line. I need a good cross mark at center front so I know where the collar ends. That's right there. And let's just give it one more look. It's convertible because we should be able to sort of open it out like that as well if your shirt isn't buttoned all the way up, or you know, some don't even have buttons here. So it's good to see what your shape might look like when it's opened up. Maybe I need to be a bit more angled. I'm going to consider coming here instead of there. Yeah. Okay, I will take it off and true it up on the table.